be commended for so sitting down. Truly, I do want to join you. This is a fantastic meeting. It's an incredibly long meeting. It's a testimony. It's a testimony to your role as a Holy Spirit that you sat in those seats and listened and paid attention. I am curious about something that I need to ask about, but I noticed that there's nothing coming into the record. The only thing that I've seen happen is a quarter of a mile is Mike's video, so I'm a little curious about that. Because a lot of people say, she is still taking the same way. I'm going to make you some money from 24 to residents in the same small business owner in my home. This is about 3.1 miles from where the place is going to be. I'm going to take the assumption now, because you've heard so many passionate things, and I'll echo all of them in terms of the environment, great ways to be said in terms of the reserves and the family. I'm going to make the assumption that you might be looking for now. Is something in the way nuts and bolts that actually allow you to say, okay, so you can't be free. You're going to say, well, but you've got to give us a better reason. You've got to give us a real nuts and bolts kind of practical reason. This is what I'm going to point out because I haven't really thought about it. It's simply this. You talk about track, and you're going to be able to refer to that on the track, and you're going to be like, statistics that you're going to go to. But what nobody's talking about is the fact that because of this close site location, everybody that's in the community is very familiar with what happens on I-12. I-12 corridor is known for accidents, lane closures, events, everything. I left here a few hours ago to be in the water. The off ramp was closed. So it was a red line off ramp. Now, should that happen during the fracking of the well, when you need the New York Department of Environmental Concerns, it's 895 to 1,350 truckloads of equipment staying in the water. That means that those 18 wheelers, which max out at about 80,000 pounds apiece, those 2,000 to 3,000 18 wheelers, men can't get on the interstate. And if you notice, the only way that they go east and west is if the rest of the highway 10A go down Highway 59, which is a two lane road, very 16 feet wide, progress through Old Main on 4th Avenue. Follow through on Highway 22 to go to Madisonville, across the swing bridge, which I have a feeling is not rated for that kind of contract, and then proceed on down Highway 22 through Montezuma and use that road to save highways. Now, that's the only way to go. So, if there's ever a reason that they can't go to the they have to go down. But more importantly, I want to tell you this. I spent about 2 months this summer driving 10,000 miles across this country. One of the things I learned is that 18-year-old partners are waiting for 2 weeks. They want to take the fastest route they can, and they want to stay off that road. I took that road trying to stay over 18-year-olds. But in Oklahoma, in Kansas, what I found was the 18-year-olds on the back highways. Why? I asked one. And he said, it's simply this. The interstates are shot because we use them so much, the interstates are running out. So we take them back roads, and then as we get into the concrete stands, the front of the towns is dried up. As a truck driver. So if there's no other reason to consider denying this permit, it has to be because there is no east-west egress for this site. The only way they can do that is to build a residential development.